Hi everybody! So today I'm going to be showing you three super easy DIY treats for the Christmas time. So we're going to start off with this hot chocolate kit, which can also double as a really great gift. So for this you need a mason jar, some mini marshmallows, and some hot chocolate. Take a look at the 5 and 10, listening once again. So you're going to start off by filling up your mason jar with hot chocolate. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. And then you're going to grab a second mason jar and fill it up with your mini marshmallows. Is the holly that will be on your own front door. A pair of hop-along boots and a pistol that shoots is the wish of Barney and Ben. Dolls will talk and we'll go for a walk. So to decorate your mason jars, it's really up to you. You can choose whichever you think looks best. I just took some cooking twine and wrapped it around the neck of each jar and then put a little knot. And then I took a label. This is just a gift label, and I attached it onto the string. One in the park as well. Sturdy kind that doesn't mind. I also found these super cute mini chalkboard clips, and so I used them to list what each mason jar contained. So on the first one I have hot chocolate, and on the second one I have marshmallows. And I just attached them by clipping them onto the string. Right within your heart. And that's how they came out. I really like this idea. I think it's super cute. And for the next craft, we're going to make these chocolate stir sticks, which are just melted chocolate that I flavored and then put into molds and use it to stir your hot chocolate. So for this, you need some sticks, some chocolate molds, some mini marshmallows, some milk and white chocolate chips, and then some flavoring. So I chose vanilla, almond, and peppermint. So you're going to start off by melting your chocolate chips, and I just did this in the microwave 30 seconds at a time, and make sure that you stir every single time until you get this consistency. Next you're going to pour some into a separate bowl and then use your flavoring. So when I added the flavoring, I found that the chocolate actually solidified a bit, so you need to act quickly and use your fingers to push the chocolate into the mold, because it's a lot easier than using a spoon. And then just damp your finger a little bit and use it to smooth out the tops. It's totally fine, it comes out just as good. And then grab your sticks and add them into the bottom half of the chocolate mold. Oh, but it's cold outside. Then once you've added your sticks in, just add some extra melted chocolate onto the top layer just to smooth it out a bit and hold the sticks in place, and it'll also help the mini marshmallows adhere to the sticks. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Once they're frozen, it's super easy to get them out of the molds. Just twist it around a little bit and then they should pop right out. And there you go. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. When we finally kiss goodnight, how I hate going out in the storm. But if you really hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm. Now just use your fingers to break off any of the excess chocolate that's around the edges, just to clean up the actual design a little bit. And there you go, that's the final product. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Oh, it doesn't show signs of stopping. So to decorate it a little bit, I just wrapped some of this glittery sticky tape around it, and then I didn't find that it held them as tightly as I wanted them to, so I added some cooking twine and just tied a plain old knot around it, and I found these to be absolutely adorable. Sleigh bells ring, are you listening? In the lane, snow is glistening. And that's it, guys. I love the way these turned out. I find these to be the perfect gift to go with the hot chocolate kits that I showed you before. So basically, to use it, you just make yourself a big hot cup of hot chocolate and then use these chocolate sticks to stir your hot chocolate. And as it sits there, it'll slowly melt and flavor your hot chocolate. So if you made one chocolate peppermint, then your hot chocolate's gonna taste like chocolate peppermint. I absolutely love it. I think it's such an adorable gift idea, perfect for the cold nights. So the last treat I'm going to show you guys are just these super cute and easy to make snowmen. So for this, you're going to need some long skewers, some milk chocolate chips, some medium-sized marshmallows, some pretzel sticks, and you're also going to need some Oreos. We're going to start off by stacking 3 medium-sized marshmallows on top of each other on each of the skewers, and then get some of your milk chocolate chips and then microwave them to melt them, the same technique as before. So now what you're going to do is, according to how many snowmen you're making, you're going to dip 1 marshmallow per snowman into the milk chocolate, and this is going to be part of their top hats. Seems like everyone but me is in love. Santa, can you hear me? Then you're going to do the same thing with the Oreos. You only need 1/2 an Oreo per snowman. And when you're dipping your Oreos, make sure that the stuffing part is face up and it's not being covered by chocolate. And once they're all covered, you're just going to put them in the freezer for at least 1/2 an hour. And while those are hardening, we're going to start working on some of the decorations for the snowman. So here I'm just taking some fruit by the foot, and I'm going to measure it around one of the snowman bodies to see how long I want the scarf to be. And then I'm going to cut it and use it as a stencil to cut out 2 others for the rest of the snowman. Now, I got the fruit by the foot that was half blue, half red, because it's sliced right down the middle, so it's easier for me to get the right size. But you guys can use a regular one or even something else. It's completely up to you guys. So I chose to cut off any remaining of the blue just because it was making me nervous and I just wanted to. But you guys can leave it if you'd like. So now to assemble the top hat, you're just going to add some melted chocolate to where the filling of the Oreos was, and then add the marshmallow portion on top and squeeze it really tightly so that it sticks. And try to cover the entire middle portion with chocolate. Don't show any of the white and kind of hide the chocolate as well, because it just adds for a nicer effect. And to attach it to the marshmallow body, just add that milk chocolate on top of the marshmallow and then add the hat on top. And then for arms, I'm using these pretzel sticks and just sticking them into each side of the snowman. And now I'm just adding the scarf onto the snowman. So to attach the scarves onto them, what I did is I dipped my finger in a little bit of water and I used that to attach everything together, because this water with the actual fruit by the foot made it sticky and made it adhere. Now you guys can choose to add some eyes and buttons to your snowman. I did 2 with and 1 without so you could see it, and I just used a toothpick and some melted chocolate. I love these ideas, guys. I find these to be super cute. I hope you enjoyed watching and that it inspired you a little bit to do some of these yourselves. I'm going to be making more Christmas-inspired videos, guys, so make sure you stay tuned. I'll see you next time. But I can't stop staring at your face. I should be playing in the winter snow, but I'ma be under the mistletoe. Are you?